I have seen a few tutorials out there about how to use ChatGPT with Midjourney to create its prompts, but I feel like there's something missing.
She's right, there is something missing.
The results can be unpredictable, and most of them are actually focused on the paid version of ChatGPT, the version 4. So if I have the version 3.5, which is free, what do I do then? So I want to show you in this video what I did to optimize the way that I use ChatGPT in order to create my prompts for Midjourney. And for that, you're gonna need some understanding of how Midjourney works, what you can do with commands, with parameters. The more you know about Midjourney, the better you can explain to ChatGPT what he should do, what he can do, or she, the bot. And I highly recommend that you have the Midjourney documentation open as well on a different tab so that you can modify on the go all the instructions that you give to ChatGPT in order to achieve what you're looking for. But before we start, I just want to say welcome back, or welcome if you're new here. I am Bella, and if you like this type of content, don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any new content, and like this video if you enjoy it, leave your comment. I love reading all your thoughts. Everything helps with the crazy YouTube algorithm, so thank you in advance. Let's do this. Okay, so the first thing we need is a template. And by template, I mean the structure that the prompt needs to have so that we can use in Midjourney to obtain our images. So for example, a template would be the prefix, the scene, the suffix, and the parameters, or the prefix, the scene, the suffix, or you can be even more specific if you're looking for images, for example, always with a cat in it. You can break it apart and say that your template has a suffix, a cat, a location or an environment, and a suffix and parameters, whatever you want to add afterwards. So you can play a bit around with these templates, remove one of these items, add another one, to see if you can better work around these structures to achieve what you are looking for. For the example in this video, I'm going to go with the most simple one that allows GPT to run wild and free to generate creative outputs for me so I can generate images on Midjourney. So let's teach ChatGPT how our prompts should look like following this template. So first we start defining to the bot the basic anatomy of this prompt. Here, basic prompt anatomy. And how does a prompt for Midjourney should look like? Well, it should start at least with the command imagine. That's the command that generates images. But you know that. You know that. I know. And here we add our template. It should have a prefix, scene, and a suffix. Now, in reality, when you're yourself writing prompts to Midjourney, these elements can actually overlap each other, right? Let's inform ChatGPT that this can happen. And we are going to use like parentheses here and just say that these categories can overlap. Now we have to explain what each of these elements is. So we go ahead and we start with the prefix. And the prefix should define the image artistic medium and the style. One thing that I add that I noticed after using for a while is that it doesn't know that it can actually use artists' names, for example, to follow the same artistic style. So let's tell him that. He can also use artists' names to follow their styles and color patterns, color palettes, for example. And now for the scene, it simply defines the content and the theme, right? What is supposed to be in that picture? If there's a person in there, if there's an animal, where it is, so characters and environment. Great, and the suffix modulates the prefix and the scene. It can give more emphasis to one element than another, it can set the vibe, the mood of the picture, the mood of that image. Amazing. And now another thing you can do, you can also give ChatGPT an example of how that prompt should look like. You can use any prompt that you have already used in the past and you liked the results. And with this example that you provide to ChatGPT, it's going to permutate, to iterate through the same structure that you have there, but with new ideas and new sentences. But the structure is going to be very similar to your example. So you can try with and without and see what fits best for you. Amazing. And now to separate our instructions from our request, I'm going to use here 3 hashtags. And now we can request. I want 10 new prompts. That's the way they should look like. And I want them to illustrate the theme gaming. And once we hit enter, these are the results that we get. So let's go to Midjourney now and see what we can get from these prompts generated by ChatGPT. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna copy one of these resulting prompts from GPT and paste in Midjourney, and we have like a comic style one, which is pretty cool. And by the way, if there any of these images is really appealing, you really like how it looks like, and you would like to use for book covers, for printing t-shirts, or whatever you want, don't forget to check it out, my other video about how to upscale these images so that you have enough resolution for printing. Let's see another one of these images now. Let's see this nostalgic tribute to gaming history. We get a bunch of colorful controllers and video games. Now, another thing you can do to increase even more your possibilities to generate a specific art is using permutations in Midjourney. So I'm going to teach ChatGPT how to create prompts using these variations, these permutations. I'm going to copy what we previously used as an input for instructions to GPT and just change a little bit some stuff and paste here in the input field. And now we are going to add the information required so that the GPT knows how he can create prompts using these variations. So let's say that he can group, that you can group variations in lists like this. Okay. Perfect. And now how permutation works in Midjourney. You just have to add different elements for the same component inside brackets. For example, you can generate three different prefixes. So we open brackets, prefix 1, 2, and 3. We can have two different scenes, scene 1, scene 2, or suffix 1 and 2. And Midjourney itself is going to iterate through all the possibilities that you have there and create four images for each one of those possibilities. But it's important to remember that each one of these items inside this list has to be a single word or a phrase without comma, because otherwise you're gonna break the syntax. So we have to let GPT know as well. So we're gonna say important, otherwise we break the syntax. Perfect. And now, instead of create 10 prompts that illustrate the theme gaming, I'm gonna change gaming to cat. Because why not? Everything with cats is good. So let's keep cat here. And now, I also want it to have two different variations for... I think different variations is a redundancy. So, two variations for prefix and three variations for scene. And we hit enter to see what we get. Awesome, so these are our results. And as you can see, we have these brackets now containing two items, which are the two prefix that we asked. And there's the second one contain the second list after the comma has three different elements for three different scenes. Each of these prompts is going to generate six different images, right? Two times three possibilities, so we'll have six prompts out of one. I'm going to copy one of those, like this one with the dreamy landscape, and paste on Midjourney. And you can see here that as soon as you press enter, Midjourney is going to ask you, are you sure about what you're doing? Do you know what you're doing? This is going to generate six different prompts. Do you want us to create all those images? This is important because, of course, the more images you make, the more GPU time you use. So I'm gonna say yes. Oh, and by the way, there's also this button here that allows you to preview all the prompts that are going to be used out of this permutation prompt. So if I click here, you can see there's a list and you can see all the possible variations out of that permutation prompt. And here we have our first cat with our first prefix, which is acrylic painting. And oh my god, I really like them. Look at this. It's a bit Van Gogh style as well, I feel like. But they are so colorful, so beautiful. I love it. And our second acrylic painting with our second scene. This time, bold and vibrant colors everywhere. Oh, look at these cats. They are so beautiful. Even ugly cats are beautiful cats. There are no ugly cats. And our fourth image is already now the second prefix, the second option, which is this artwork. But with now we go through these three different scenes with the second option of prefix, right? So we get these different cats. Oh my god, this one is beautiful. I love this one. But it has too many ears. Look, the cat has 3 ears. This covers everything, but it's really important that you keep practicing, that you keep, you know, alternating between these different elements. As I said, you can add new things to your template. I am going to leave a link down below. If not now, if it's still not there, you can come back a little bit later. As soon as possible, I'm going to put this in a shareable Google Docs, all the possibilities that you can use that I have already used. I also have already done a list of the parameters, and ChatGPT uses the parameters a little bit randomly. So just be certain that you check them out. If you don't like one of those suggestions, you can change it. But I got some pretty wild things, some pretty good things. It's very different. I'm gonna leave everything there, and I hope you get the most beautiful images. And the best part is, even if you have the free GPT version, you keep your conversation there. So you just have to teach GPT in one chat once, and then you can use it forever. So, I mean, forever, it's a huge word. Maybe there's no more GPT in 100 years. I don't know. But anyway, I hope you guys like it. I hope this was super useful for you. I hope you enjoyed. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, please. And again, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Please consider doing it so. It helps a lot with this YouTube crazy algorithm. It's been a battle. I can only say that. It's been a fight, you know? And yeah, I hope you have a lovely rest of the day, wherever you are, morning, day, night. Thank you so much for watching, and I see you guys in the next one. Bye!